years.
You have heard my voice for years.
My voice for years.
You have heard my voice for years. I am your mother.
And I have been around since
the beginning of time.
I've seen every legend. I've lived every tale. I am the word that travels all the wind. Listen! Not bad. You will know my trinity as Eerie. I am the blessing for the people of the Emerald Isle.
For those that call.
Did you hear it?
Oh, she's cooing so sweetly.
As if she were a little lark.
Let us fly like the lark.
A ship sails soon, Eerie.
My spirit will follow. Something calls us on the wind.
Well, she wasn't always a witch. She was just a lady. A lady with long gray hair and wore a black dress. Or no, she had long red hair and wore a white dress. Or maybe her hair was silver. Either way, she was a lady, got it? And on the day of this lass's death, she was having a real bad time. A real pissed-
Liam!
Well, it wasn't sunshine and roses now, was it? What do you think she screams every time someone croaks?
The story isn't very good. Maybe Mum could write it down?
No self-respecting Irishman writes a story down. They're meant to be shared, and Liam will do a fine job telling them. He just needs a bit of inspiration, or maybe just a good mouth rinsing.
You have a little faith in your brother, yeah?
A little.
Look, if you ever get scared, just hold on to your clover. It'll protect you. Give you luck.
Luck from a praying woman.
A mother will take any blessing she can. Now don't you tease me. Old world or new.
Can't we stay here in Liverpool? It's not so bad.
We can't be filling my auntie's house any longer. If you can find passage down at the pier, you can find a new life.
All of us?
It'll be grand. Soon.
You're coming.
Liam, I have to work. Your father's money only pays for two trips. This is what's best for Shannon.
But if I can help save the fields, Mom.
Picking at the soils won't do them no good. It's what's on the soil that's causing the trouble. Now hurry up. You were meant to be at the pier at least an hour ago.
But the coffin chips.
No more guff. It'll take you home, love. Your brother will make sure of it.
He's not even a grown-up. He's just a brother. And that's not the same thing.
Quit your worrying, Shannon. Mom's right. Coffin chips. It's only a name. You can call him whatever you like.
Oh, I love you both very much. And no matter where you go, you can't escape my love for you. I'll send it on the wind.
Love you, Ma. Slan.
Slan. May God hold you both in the palm of his hands, my gallant little soldiers. Now off with yous before I can tie you down.
Thank you.
I know more than you. I'm just keeping an eye out.
If you ain't got the right coin, try swimming.
G'day, sir.
What do you want, boy?
Passage, sir. To Canada.
Out to Canada? Any part in particular? Or you want me to leave you about the icebergs, eh?
Icebergs!
Ain't this a long journey for a young Mick and his pup?
I don't want to leave Mom.
Shannon, we have to go.
Hey, hey!
What?
We're opening up the hole again. 15 more, and that's it.
All right, 15, 15. Right, 15, 14, 15, 12,
15,
11,
20, 11, 10,
11, 9, 8, number 8. You think I can't tell teeth from shillings? I don't care, they're yours. We'll move on. 7.
We're off.
6.
Ship. We've got 5.
4. Wait. 3. 2. And 1. Well, looks like the little pups learned how to swim then, eh?
Coming, Liam?
You only paid me a full white, you little runt.
You've got to understand.
I don't trust you, though.
Come on, Ed!
Why, you cheeky little...
Edward!
Are we at optimal capacity?
Plenty optimal, Captain.
It appears I've gained a passenger.
Sorry about that, sir. Just some stubborn riffraff.
But we paid.
Underpaid. 5 shillings. And we've only got enough room for one more set.
Ma told us to go, and I'm doing what Ma says.
Well. This one is only half a fan. He's only half the size. We must have enough room for 1.5 more passengers. Right, Edward?
Right, of course, sir. Of course we did. Right this way, gentlemen.
Go, Rabbi Mai Gafahara.
Thank you.
We've already lost one soul today. There's no need for another two.
One soul, Captain.
A young man fell from the side of the ship.
Are you a superstitious man, Captain? Because you know what this means, eh?
I know that I'm a captain. But we have much greater things to worry about than fear. From the land of Kosh she came, sailed the rigging banners flying high. Captains on the quarterdeck, gazing at the ever-changing sky. Oh, the sky. Says they cut the ropes, the devil's on the rise. Tie down the hatch, trim the sails,
cut it out!
The frightened first mate cries. Oh, ye cries. Lightning snaps, silent faces frozen in the wind. Worried stares, anxious prayers, hoping that the Lord will see them in. Ragged sails are blindly by the gear. Churning seas, worthless pleas, echoes with the cries of more the rain. changing sky. Oh, the sky. He pulled the wind. Oh, bless you.
Bless you. Quebec be our home, Shannon. For you, Ma, and I.
How much longer?
Well, the ocean isn't a pond now, is it? No matter what you heard in Liverpool, Brits couldn't tell the truth to save their life.
Excuse me.
Oh, Lord.
But you can't repeat yourself, young man.
I'd rather not.
Oh, this is grand.
Oh, I don't mean to be ear-picking. I just didn't know Queen Victoria was here.
Oh, Queen Victoria. Helena, if you please. Helena Croxley. Looking for a laugh?
Finnegan McCarthy, Your Majesty. And if I was looking for a laugh, see, you should have knocked me stiff. You all right there, lad?
How much longer? A few days?
More than just a few, I'm afraid.
Why are so many people coughing?
Couldn't be that fire that old fogey is sucking on.
If you wanted to puff, you should have just gave me a nudge.
Remember, Marshan, where's your luck? Still green? What would Mommy say? I don't know.
Would you put that out?
That's what came from the rear of...
She'd be so proud. You're being a brave lad.
Mom!
Hi, Jen. I got you.
Do you like stories there, Pop? Your mom, she was an Irish lass, yeah? She must have told you boys and tales.
Ma was a storyteller. Told adventures from thin air.
Well, how'd you like to hear one? Mickey Relican has a wolf paw. He was reared in the elegant style. For 17 hours of battle he fought, and he kept tied himself by the log. His head was a neat little bit of a stump, bow-legged with two crooked eyes. Oh, and look at his ugly mug was enough. 'Twas the devil himself in disguise. Bow, wow, wow, what a wonderful dog. For fighting he'd never give up. There never was such a wonderful dog as old Mickey Relican's pup. He tore the tail off Maloney's best coat, made the dress off of Marianne Flynn, and then he ran between young Mitty Mullins' knees. Now wasn't that truly a sin? And then he took off with the shoemaker's dog, and he shook him around like a rat, and then he frightened Jim Flaherty's beautiful coat in the tail off of Mullins' hat. Wow, wow, what a wonderful dog. For fighting he'd never give up. There never was such a wonderful dog as old Mickey Relican's pup.
Mickey
but he choked on his tail and he died. Wow, 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 what a wonderful dog. Bird fights and he never give up. Bird fights and he never give up. Oh, there never was all such a wonderful dog as he
back home with it. Oh well, no use now.
I could do with a little more light.
A little more air. I'm not sure how much more of this sailing I can take.
I don't mean to judge, but perhaps you're in the wrong class. God, Buckles.
Some privacy!
Why, Shannon, I've got you.
The men next to me! Dear, calm yourself. The man next to me? We're packed so close together. He was just standing next to me.
Is someone causing trouble?
No, no trouble. No, no trouble at all. No, not anything at all.
You stay here and then I'll find some lads to move him elsewhere.
To where? There isn't any space left. Well, he can't just be left in the hold.
What's wrong?
Passengers! Those men are on deck! Quickly now!
It's all so blue.
The heart of the Atlantic.
Attention! Captain John Mountbay wishes to address his passengers.
Now, I understand that this fortune has made its way onto the ship. And for that, I give my deepest sympathies. As captain, I take full responsibility for the loss that has befallen us. But I urge that we must continue. We will need the help of every able-bodied man to move those with illness from the hold to the deck. As for the hold, we will get rid of what waste we can and cleanse the rest with wine.
Lime? We can hardly breathe in the hold as it is.
Quiet while the captain is...
George, I understand we are limited in our crew and materials. We must utilize what cargo we have. For now, we will keep the fore scuttle open and cut holes in the side of the ship for air. We will see Quebec. And so, we must abide by my judgment. George, my first mate and I, will assist in caring for those with illness on the deck. The air will do them good. The air. Quickly!
What else were they to do?
They could only watch time pass. Nearly two new moons. But I feel something blue. It's a flower.
In the water?
In the middle of a river. A rose. Something beautiful.
Your Honor, with
these conditions and to be denied—
Chad is not denying medical care, nor provisions.
Then when are we to receive these luxuries, Your Honor? We need to land. Over 100 of my passengers are dead, and more will die the longer we wait. Women and children.
Well, Chad isn't quite an uproar since the arrival of Richard White. And no wonder, they have a reason to be afraid. Disease? Malnutrition?
Savagery. There's no reason to be afraid of the dead. I wish to be granted permission on the matter of boarding Middle Island soon. Very soon.
Peace, Captain. We will find a common ground.
Oh, then tell me, Sean O'Farrell, where the gathering is to be.
In the Eagle, by the river, quite well known to you and me.
One forward for signal token, Miss Alatha marching too. With your pike upon your shoulder at the rising of the moon.
At the rising of the moon, on the rising of the moon. With your pike upon your shoulder at the rising of the moon.
Mr. Kennard.
Honorable Joseph Kennard.
Honorable Joseph Kennard. Surely you can sympathize.
Oh, it's horrific. It's terrible. I'll have my steamer tow your vessel up river to the island in a jet.
Middle island.
My island, free of charge. Not for you.
My thanks. And when may we land?
On my word.
There beside the singing river, a dark mass of men were seen.
Far above the shining crescent, hung their roaming murder green.
Woe to every foe and traitor, forward strike the marching tune.
And proud my voice for freedom, 'tis the rising of the moon.
Travelers which legally boarded the Vushtuk.
They decided to let it spread. Who knows to what level they can be trusted? Middle Island is my property, but further discussion will be needed before I put my acreage at risk.
And put these fine people in Chatham at risk? This could be a disaster.
I couldn't agree more.
Certainly you understand, Captain. Captain?
Honorable Joseph Jack, Your Honor, as Captain, I feel as though I can fairly judge that we have been waiting long enough. If I am not granted permission to Middle Island to bury our dead, I will run this ship ashore. Regardless, this already is a disaster.
He was there.
Wait!
And with that, the Vushtuk crashed ashore with the waves.
Thank you.
clear. This way. We're off the boat.
You all right, Helena?
Fine, thank you. Just some of us could be happy to
see sand. A tall grass.
A free pup ring Finnegan. Finn?
He's probably off with the other men. I'll go check on him. Can't be far.
Everything all right?
Of course.
Leo, where's Finn?
He's off. He's off helping with those who need to be buried, Shannon, but he'll be back.
Oh. Well, we're off the ship. Shannon, feel the sun?
He'll be back. Let's set up camp, okay, Shan?
Okay.
What was that?
Look! The men are on the shore! They have muskets!
It's one of the ships!
The Richard White?
Another one! Coming down the river! I don't think it's stopping!
Well, they have to stop, don't they? They're firing at the ship!
Mom! Shannon!
Toward the wood! He can't go far!
Thank you.
Mother!
Oh, sweet spirit. I am your mother,
and I have been around
since the beginning of time.
Oh, don't retreat, young spirit.
Fully clover, four!
Oh, there she is. How is my little beauty?
Oh, she hasn't changed a leaf. What was that?
Are you listening to the clover?
She's just seen her third full moon!
What did you do with her?
Wait, wait, wait! Oh, she's singing.
Singing? The clover is singing?
The blessing from beyond the sea
and the green hills.
Who are you?
I am Eerie.
Is that a family name?
I speak for Ireland.
Oh, like Earing Go Bra, Ireland forever.
Forever and always. Is that your home, young spirit?
I don't know.
Well, if you were only visiting, we hope you like our gift anyways.
The same voice that blessed your clover told us about the roses. Told us about you.
I knew it was Ma. What did you do with her?
Shh. As my voice calls, a voice calls me here. My spirit is of the land, and to protect all living things that heed my call. Your clover has more than love. It is a bond that cannot be broken, and I must protect you.
I must protect you.
I must protect you.
So, you are here
for you and for the one that called. We've been waiting. Look at your clover, less than all this time.
Rather marvelous. Fresh as the day it was plucked.
Liam won't believe this.
Oh, the other spirit, your brother.
He was supposed to look after me.
Oh, has he not? You've made it here.
Where is he now?
I can sense his presence. He is close.
Sure.
Very close.
Come here, Shannon. What if I want to stay?
This isn't time for games.
Eerie came from Ireland to protect us.
Eerie? Who's Eerie?
The spirit. She's right there.
We've journeyed as you have, from the shores.
Across the ocean.
This island in the middle of the river.
You have to listen to me now, Shannon. I'm sorry I'm not Ma, but it's time to quit messing around.
What? Look at this clover. It's still green. Eerie saved it because she's the spirit of Ireland. How else could you explain it?
She saved it. This clover.
That is a bit peculiar.
She said she's here to protect us. Ma sent her. That's why she gave us roses. Ma always loved roses. Can you still not see her?
I heard rumors on the ship of an omen. Something calling us here. The natives of this land believe that this island is cursed. That a demon lives here.
We are not a demon!
Look, this is all quite foolish and I've had enough. We don't have time for this fantasy, Shannon. We don't need games. We need a shelter. Come on.
They won't listen. I'm sorry.
If you wish to seek us again, only call.
That was our last chance. Now we're stuck.
We're not stuck, Shannon. We'll find a way.
One island to the next.
Heavens, where have you all been? We must head back to the camp.
Oh, just one moment. Please pardon my indecency.
That felt bloody brilliant.
Did you find Finn?
Well, that's just it, dearie. Well, I found him, yes, amongst the others. I'm afraid he isn't well.
Perhaps it was the spirit?
Molly, don't encourage him.
Where is he?
He needs to rest. Shannon!
Shannon!
I'll get him. Liam, there are no doctors on the island.
None?
No. No doctors, no volunteers. Only the captain and his first mate are managing the sick. Seems that fear of dying is what's keeping the people of Chatham on shore. I've only heard of one name, one chance. But at this point, it sounds like a legend. Finnegan will need a doctor.
Our one chance? What's the name of this doctor?
Dr. Vondi, I believe. Dr. John Vondi.
Perhaps it's time we start believing in legends.
But wouldn't you know it? My pipe was nowhere to be found.
Probably off with the pigs. Clever creatures, those pigs.
More clever than some. Then?
Yes, Father? What, you think I'd take me on Father's pipe?
You say you didn't. You swear?
I swear! Hand to God!
Put your arm down, lad. The Lord has no blessings for pigs.
I wasn't going to smoke much.
Oh, corned beef and cabbage. You're only 10 feet. You got to be more responsible. Think about what your mother must be feeling. You've got to think with your heart sometimes, and not your head. It's got more sense. Now, why don't you go on home, apologize to Ma, and have yourself a good old pray.
No. Wait. Let the boys stay a while, and the band is about to get going.
Oh, so the boy can make a fool of himself?
No. You have to admit that Finny's got away with words, and he's not too bad with his feet either. Brightens up the spirits of the boy and the new fancy lady. Right, boys?
Once upon a time, a young man, the spitting image of Finnegan, raised his voice in song in this old pub.
What a rough boy, lovey.
Oh, hush up, you.
That's right. Pardon, Father.
Wait. Look. Have a drink. Soothe your nerves. That might do you some good to relive the glory days.
You know what, boy? Why don't you go and make a fool for the both of us?
Oh, come. Just one. For me.
Aye, me too.
Ah, it is worth my own flesh and blood. All right. One song. And then we're off.
One song? Got it.
What?
Oh, I just think you might be needing another ale.
Good to see you. Good to see you. Now, tonight is a very special night. Now, I've had many a night. As this is one of my very, very few times in Lovey's Tavern, the brother of Lovey and the old fathers decide to join us for a brew.
Yay!
What a pack of dogs we got here! Now I know what you're all thinking. Times are rough. I mean, why else are we out here, right? But there's one thing we have to remember. What a beauty this land is. Every bit is splendid. Rattling, you could say.
Rattling bar, the bar down in the valley, oh. I hold rattling bar, the bar down in the valley, oh. I hold rattling bar, the bar down in the valley, oh. I hold.
fascinating. Don't try any of that charm on me, Mr. McCarthy. Try and stay awake.
I was just trying to find a way off the island last.
Find any place nice?
Why? Nothing nice. How about you, lad?
He's been quite the man since Liam went off. Hasn't said a word. You're still hot!
You flatter me.
That may work on some women, Mr. McCarthy, but unlike most women, I have different priorities.
So you didn't make the cross for a husband, then?
Well, flirting's fine. But a woman should be able to look beyond the prospects of a man. Besides, the men should be giving us a little more respect considering how interested you all seem to be.
How's your record?
Will you name all of your favorite things after us? Calling this and that she for some reason. Ships, horses, carriages, even the day. She's a fine evening. She's quite the vessel.
How's she going?
I understand these things may be your property, but I don't intend for that.
Not even for Liam.
What? Liam is fine and has treated us all well, but a man and a woman can exist together as friends now, can't they?
All right, all right. Enjoy your life as the town spinster. Oh, Lady Helena, we were just talking about you.
I haven't the faintest idea of what you're talking about. Still, might I suggest, Molly, that your soothing cloth might serve better purpose as a gag for Mr. McCarthy? Heaven forbid he bite his tongue.
Any luck finding food?
I was just at the tents. The captain had smoked veal bread and I took what I could. People of Chatham have allowed us a small libation. Sent over some of their own meals with the workers repairing the sheds.
Oh, how nice. Ugh. While we're sitting here eating sandwiches, this'll give them a chance to pack more gunpowder. Actually, you know what? Why don't we send the sandwiches back? That way, it'll give us a chance to swim upriver.
Hold your tongue.
What about the Dr. Bondi?
The doctor? Oh, he'll make his way around soon.
Is he on the island?
If he isn't yet, it'll be very soon. The southwest end was packed with pastors from the Richard White, and I didn't dare get lost in its commotion. The doctor will help just what Finnegan needs.
You know what Finnegan really needs?
Oh, if you mention that filthy pipe once more!
Oh, can't you honor a dying Irishman's last wish?
Don't be so dramatic. Sucking on that ashiness would be the only thing killing you. I swear, if I find that pipe between your lips after I've schooled the island all day...
You'll what? Find something else to put there? How about a kiss, then?
The indecency! The incivility!
Ow. What a lady.
What's the commotion?
Liam! Find Dr. Bondi?
Not yet, Shannon, but we will.
We should go see Eerie. She's here to protect us.
Shannon, I told you to quit playing games.
But she's magic.
Well, so is the doctor, Shannon.
Liam's right. Even if she is real, which she isn't, she could be a banshee or a golem. Not all spirits are meant to be trusted, you know.
We need something, medicine or magic.
Might I suggest a bit of both? Oh, didn't mean to cause a fright. Quiet nature and quiet soul, you understand. I mean you no harm. Truth be told, I've come to bring you a little peace.
Where did you come from? Nobody can cross the river.
Did you come from the tents? Or the ship?
I come from Utopia, a place free from all the ails of the human world. And from this world I come bearing its gifts. Behold! Elixir of unimaginable value. Your friend looks like he could use such a brew.
Our apologies, sir. This all sounds quite marvelous, but we haven't even properly met.
Oh, of course, my apologies. I do so get carried away with my brew. Why, I've just had a spoonful, and I've been going all day. Allow me to introduce myself.
Please, the day, make it
fourteen is making, and I have a way of verifying that here. I can make a drop that's pure, and there's nothing that won't cure. It surpasses any medicine or pill, because it tastes as sweet as honey as it trickles down your throat. It looks as clear as pure as morning dew, and it could make a fella sing, though he didn't have no. Would you try a drop of Paddy Kelly's brew? It'll cure your rheumatism, it'll cure rheumatism's chest, it'll cure you of the gout and cause the flu. It cures toothache, headache, back and fallen hair and all the rest, fallen arches, bones and bunions and the flu. Because it tastes as sweet as honey as it trickles down your throat, it looks as clear and pure as morning dew. And it could make a fella sing, though he didn't have a note. Try a drop of Paddy Kelly's brew. Many summer days you'll find me catching salmon in the glen, or set snares for rabbits on the hill. But the nicest thing of all is when evening shadows fall, just to watch the bubbles within that white bill. Because it tastes as sweet as honey as it trickles down your throat, it looks as clear and pure as morning dew. And it could make a fella sing, though he didn't have no. I'm a founder who's a spend, and a motto for a friend. I have customers who know who buy my brew. At a wedding or a wake, I supply the stuff they take, and I keep a good supply for your crew. Because it tastes as sweet as honey as it trickles down your throat, it looks as clear and pure as morning dew. And it could make a fella sing, though he didn't have a note. Would you try a drop of Paddy Kelly's brew? Now I know you will confess that the world is in mess. The politicians don't know what to do. I can offer them a plan that'll cure the human man. Throw away the guns and hand out Paddy's brew. Because it tastes as sweet as honey as it trickles down your throat. It looks as clear and pure as morning dew. And it would make a fella sing, though he didn't have a note. Would you try a drop of Paddy Kelly's brew? Because it tastes as sweet as honey as it trickles down your throat. It looks as clear and pure as morning dew. And it would make a fella sing, though he didn't have a note. Would you try a drop of Paddy Kelly's brew?
Lovely love. So, how are you paying?
Well, you must understand, sir, we don't have much.
Of course, of course. I know you don't have much, but you do have some things, don't you? Yeah. Lovely London import. Real gold.
It was a gift and certainly worth more than your brew.
I see nothing else comparable. Is it worth as much as a soul, perhaps?
What are you getting at? That's cruel.
It really means oh, you foolish foggy, would you quit your coughing?
Oh, but I'm having so much fun.
Take it.
Lovely. Been a pleasure. Hey, you. All right, thanks very much. All right, boys, get the scooter going. Let's go.
Hey, get back here.
Oh, it's poaching, all right. Nothing more.
He can't get far. The musket men on the edges will stop him.
They weren't one of the same.
Captain Dane!
Please. We're all tired. There's no need for formalities. Those men are from Chatham. The ones holding us hostage. I believe they are the robbers you just encountered.
Well, does that mean I can get my trunk back?
I'm afraid not. They've stolen before. I wish I was here in time to warn you.
But that's not fair! We're stuck here! We can't leave!
They are the shore. As long as this quarantine is in effect, they choose the ebb and flow.
Making us what? River buoys?
We need to see Erie.
We need to know, Captain. Is there a Dr. Vonley on the island? Our friend Finnegan McCarthy isn't well.
Captain!
At ease, sailor. George, my first mate and I, We're acting as doctors, near where the Richard White had landed. As you can see, I've only just touched the Northeast section. My first mate, George, only just buried him.
Our condolences, sir. May he be with God.
Thank you. You. You're the pup, aren't you?
We need to see Eerie, sir. The spirit said to protect us.
Eerie? You must have a mind for mythology.
Stories, Captain. My Ma used to tell them to me. Ma sent the spirit.
Well, you ought to listen to your mother. She knows what's best for you. I'm glad to see you well. Pardon me for my brief visit, but I must see to other passengers.
Did you hear that? Mind yourself, lad. Just because Captain Thane said to follow the spirit doesn't change what we thought before.
Well, perhaps it does.
Molly, you're agreeing with this.
I know what I said before about the island being cursed. But being stuck here, we're already cursed. With no sign of Dr. Bondi, and with what the captain just said. Shannon, be as honest as you can. Why do you believe in Eerie?
This is Ma's clover. Eerie said she saw it growing and kept it alive. Ma used to tell us of Eerie, don't you remember?
Aye. She was part of the Tuatha Danann tribe, a daughter of the king.
I used to like hearing about a magic ship that sailed through the clouds, and then it found an island, and Eerie was promised by the poet to be forever remembered as the name of Ireland.
Eerie go wrong.
Ma picked this clover before any of this happened, and it's still alive. So I have to hope that Ma is too. And Ma may have sent the spirit for us, but I think she's protecting us all.
Well, if that don't convince you, I wasn't even there, and I'd be running if my head didn't feel like trouble. Get going.
I'll watch Finley go.
We'll be back soon.
Go on, John.
S'long, Finn.
S'long. Well, now that we're alone.
Oh, Finnegan, you have such a wild imagination. To think that a lady like myself would be charmed by a brutish rogue like yourself.
What are you going on about? I was hoping for another go at me pipe.
I ought to beat you over the head with your own shillelagh.
I love it when you talk about my shillelagh. All right.
Nor I.
So why do you come?
Why are we here?
Because we have a question.
Ask away!
Ask away!
Ask away!
I would answer.
What's the question?
Where is she?
Right there, there, and there.
All right. Do you know of a Dr. Vondi?
Yes, I do.
She says she does.
Perfect. Is he here with us on the island?
She's just circling you right now, but keep talking.
Because we need this man. Because there are men with guns that keep us here. Do you know of our circumstances?
I know of your suffering before.
And that this suffering has followed as my spirit has followed.
And that suffering will continue to follow your spirits as you continue on.
She said the word suffering a lot, so that can't be good. But she said it will continue to follow us.
Are you saying that we'll be moving on?
I have said what I have said!
I don't think she can say anything else.
That's it. So what can she do?
Liam!
No, Molly. If what Sharon says is true, you're supposed to be our protector. But all you seem to be protecting is this Clover.
Where did she go?
Ah!
Liam! What's wrong?
Oh, calm yourself. You cannot help those you love by using what strength you have left to hate.
I think I see Eerie.
You do?
You do?
He does?
I do.
You're allowed to feel whatever it is you feel, Liam.
You're far from home. Your life has changed, but don't put all the weight on your shoulders.
There are those who suffer and allow it to possess them. Let it inspire you.
Inspire me? Look, I've been doing everything I can, everything I'm capable of to shelter me and my brother and act as the two people I miss the most. I have to do this because of the men on the shore, because of the men who told us to abandon our farm, because of the men in Parliament who control our lives and told me and my brother to leave our home and blamed all our misfortunes on a root. And they get away with it because we're just Irish immigrants, spoiled goods. That's it.
Liam?
This can't be happening. This can't be happening.
Can you tell me a story, Liam?
Liam?
She wants me to tell her a story. Why? Why would you want me to do that? There's no time for stories anymore.
Dare strike!
For her song is too beautiful.
The lion ranks there to this day, waiting for her song to break, unable to rupture her song of home. How was that?
Faith of Agora. It's not bad.
That can't be true.
Well, that wasn't really the point now there, was it? Wait, was it?
It is a true story.
It's a parable, Shannon. It's about what is being done to our Irish kin.
Is it?
You're just full of questions, aren't you? I told it as a parable. It's about the Irish.
Or is it just about me?
Are you a princess?
I used to feel like one. Back home, before my parents.
Both of your parents?
My mother and father. My two beautiful sisters. They're all far away now. Far, far away on the shore that I can't reach in this lifetime. I used to feel like a princess once. I wish it was only a story, but it's true.
Molly, I didn't mean to. Why torture her? I thought I was just telling a story.
You did.
I did so beautifully.
But this is a story that has been told many times before.
Academa patrie, attendant je me lis. Ma vie, ma foi sont à toi. Tu me protégeras. Tu me
song of her home. She's one of many who survived suffering like you. She's an Acadian from many years ago.
You share a story that never ended. Spirits live all along these shores. The wicked nature of some humans attempts to stifle spirits, but the compassion of humans allows spirits to thrive.
I cannot speak to the future of your kin, but your shared past can hold the fate of the future.
If you never forget, you can survive. The winds are changing.
The clouds. We have to give them a shelter.
Thank you, Eerie.
Liam, can I have my Cooper back?
All right. She's gone.
Slán, Eerie. Let's
be
go.
Be swift.
We may have our differences, but I don't wish you ill.
Not after all this.
Well, it's appreciated, Your Majesty. You said it meant something to you.
It did.
Well, I'm sorry, Anna. It was your history.
It was my fiance's.
Oh, my condolences.
If only he were dead.
I think my fever has reignited.
He was supposed to be a gentleman. Actually, a duke more like, but no matter. I was a lucky woman, you see. I was only of the upper middle class.
A tragedy, if I ever heard one.
Oh, I'm so happy you understand. But before this union, I had never dreamed of a chance of becoming royalty. Being a woman of my class, destiny offered a life of cooking and cleaning, which is a fine life, and I may not have had much more marrying a future duke, but I would finally have something I had not received much of in my life, and that was respect. But then, not even a week before the wedding, he felt as though his heart had been stolen by another. Asked me to leave him.
He had no right.
Oh, but he did. Royal blood. Gave me that suitcase to back. A gift. So I've been traveling ever since. Did enjoy its luxury. So did I have you convinced? Lady Helena.
A right fool he was.
Damned British monarchy. It may be a few too many petticoats, but I think I may have caught your fever. That's
Look at now. This rain won't do him any good.
I'll go check the tents. Quickly.
Go with Helena. Find shelter.
Liam, I can help. I'm not afraid.
Cover Finn. Stay close and shield the rain you can.
You're being very brave.
Finn, can you stand?
This rain is freezing.
Molly, help me lift Finn.
Thank you.
gently.
His heart is weak.
That's where you're wrong, Dr. Grundy.
I have it! I had to stay all night in the tents, and I ran into about three trees on the way here. But the storm couldn't... Who's this?
Oh, Dr. John Grundy, my dear. I'm terribly sorry, but your friend is...
He's real! I mean, you're real. Can you believe it? What? What is it?
You cut me a gift.
What happened?
The storm.
Took me breath away.
But one night? It couldn't have affected him that much.
I only wish I could have done more.
You've done more than most.
How can you say that?
Helena! Thank you for coming. You don't know what it means. See someone fighting alongside one of us. I know where I'm at. Go. How about another Irish soul, would you?
You're a fine man. May the Lord bless you.
I'm sure he does.
Stay strong. Hold it.
Thank you.
tell me one thing? Well, maybe you're right.
Only time will tell.
Come on. Can't you show me a bit of magic?
Just this once, Mr. McCarthy.
You're an angel.
John Bondi. Many of you, he was a savior. To me, he was my brother. And yet I find it hard to see the difference. I remember when he was leaving for Middle Island, he told me, Elizabeth, these people are just like any of us. They left what they knew was home because it's what they had to do to protect those they loved. Start again. They're scared and they're sick. Who am I to negate helping them while I am able? And now he is making his final journey with others who met at this island. But far fewer because they met him. It is time to bid them goodbye. But I will not be forgetting my brother, nor any soul on this island. And the quarantine will be lifted, and we will survive.
And will remain.
no crying, no dying, no pain. There are no tears, they are wiped dry. I will sing to you an Irish
will.
A story to be remembered.